Lynne with Vicki Lee Bags. I hope you're having a really good day. This is a project I have for you this week. This wonderful, very, very large beach bag or overnight bag, whatever you would like to use it for. Some of the features that I really like about it are the pockets in the front. They're very good size. We were able to do three, but you're going to choose however you want to do them. And there's also one of our new inset pockets on the back. This pocket is huge. So, boy, lots of room for, you know, whatever you would like to do with it. The straps are very long. They're very generous. You can, you know, wear it crossbody if you would like, or very comfortable straps for over the shoulder as well. But this thing is massive, so I like it. You can even make it bigger. You can make it a little smaller. You can just make it your own. And look, we also have a place to hang your keys so they don't get lost if you would like. So I'm ready. Let's get started on making this bag.
Okay. For this project, your focal fabric measures 21 inches wide by 16 inches in height. Okay. So that's 21 wide and 16 in height. You can revise that to be any size you want it to be. Okay. So this is just what we're going to be doing for this particular bag that I wanted to put on Etsy for sale and to show you how I'm going to make that. The lining fabric is exactly the same, okay? It's 21 inches wide by 16 inches in height. And what I've done to the focal fabric is I used that fusible fleece on the back. I do want this bag to be quilted. We're going to take it over and quilt it so that you can wash it. Okay, I love the idea that you could just throw this in the wash, take it out, you could even put it in the dryer, and this really helps it to keep its shape after it's been quilted. Okay, and then the inside here, I'm going to go ahead and do the quilting lines, but this has been lightly interfaced. It's not going to have the fleece. It doesn't need it. But I am going to go ahead and put the lines on it anyway so that in the dryer, if this should come loose, it's not going to make a mess of my liner. Okay? This is going to have the pocket on the outside. And isn't that going to be cute? I really like the little strip that we're going to put on. And this piece, the focal fabric, which I'm going to lightly interface after I put on the little strip. This piece is 21 inches long, same as our focal fabric and our liner, by 15. Because we're going to fold it in half. We're going to have this be a little decorative element on it, probably down in here like that. Okay, and I'm going to sew that on, and then I'm going to do a light interfacing. You'll be here for all of that, so that'll be a little bit more self-explanatory. Okay, we're also going to have a inset zipper pocket on the outside of the back of this, the focal part, okay? This I didn't need to line because you can't really tell from here, but it's actually a very heavy, heavy cotton, so it's perfect for a pocket. It doesn't really need anything. It is really good size, though. It is 15 inches wide by 20 and a half inches long. Right now it's just folded in half, okay? So it is 15 inches wide by 20 and a half the height. It is going to be, the zipper is going to be longer. We're going to have to cut that down because the zipper, this particular one, is 25 inches long. And I always order really long zippers now because I buy these little zipper pulls, and whatever I have left over, I put a new zipper pull and I can use the rest of the zipper for another project. Okay, and you can even find that on one of our videos that I have made one about the buying a longer zipper. It really has worked out well and it's been a good money saver. We're going to have that little strap on the inside that has the little swivel hook on it. Okay, so this little piece of fabric is 2 inches wide by 16 inches. We probably won't need it that long, but that's just kind of how I have it measured now. You can do what you want, but if you do want to have on a hook on the inside, this is how long and how wide I have it. Again, it's 2 inches by 16, and then the little hook Isn't that cute? Okay. Our straps, we have two straps, and they're 45 inches long by 6 inches wide. They're really nice, comfortable strap. They are lightly interfaced, but I'm going to show you, I put this over the part where your shoulder's going to go. It is fusible fleece, and it's really soft and cushy. And you're going to see how we use that. It's really nice. It makes it really I also wonderful. Have my little Vicky Lee bags that my friend Sean bought for me. And I like to put it on my products, especially when I'm going to sell them on Etsy. It gives my brand name a little extra advertisement. And we'll see where we go from there. I do have this button, and we'll see, you know, if I'm going to put that on or not. It does match so well, I thought it'd be kind of cute to use it, but I'm not sure yet how. So anyway, we're going to get started on this. The first thing I'm going to do, and I'm not going to do this on camera because it just gets, you know, long and redundant, is I'm going to quilt this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a large stitch length on my machine. So I'm going to make it a little bit wider is what I'm saying. I am going to go across here about every 4 inches. It doesn't need to be really close together. Again, this is fused on there. It doesn't need to be, but I want you to do whatever you would like. If you'd like to do them an inch apart, 3 inches apart, or even up to 4 inches apart, okay? On both of these, and I'm also going to do it on the inside, okay? Even though it's a soft interfacing that's fused on, I want this completely washable. I don't want anything to come apart, okay? So I'm going to do that, and I'll meet you back.
Okay, so I did finish quilting the outside pieces and the lining. Okay, so that's really going to give the bag a little bit more integrity and hold it when you do your washing of it. So the first thing we're going to do is the pocket for the outside. We're going to set these guys aside and take the outside panel and bring over this piece that has the really pretty piece that we're going to sew into the top of this. It's going to make a really cute pocket. Okay, so if you'll remember, this piece is 21 inches wide by 15 inches. Okay. And the first thing I'm going to do, let me move this aside. I'm not ready for it yet. Is I'm going to open this up to the top, to the outside fabric facing up. I'm going to set this here along the top. If this was a fabric that had a pattern, I would put right sides together. Okay, but it's not, so it doesn't really matter. And I'm going to put some pins in this. I'm going to take it over to my sewing machine, and I'm going to sew a quarter of an inch all the way along the top. Okay, so I did add the little strip of coral, and I did take it over to my ironing board, and I added some interfacing. It's just a lightweight interfacing, but I did do that afterwards so I can really make the seam lay down and be really nice and flat, okay? So at this point, what I'm going to do is I'm going to meet these two ends, right sides together, of course. I'm going to do another quarter of an inch right over here. And I'm going to turn it inside out. And I'm going to show you how I'm going to make my decision for how I want this pocket to be. Okay, so of course you can do whatever you'd like, but I'd like to show you my method of what I'm going to do. Okay, so I did do that. And now I'm going to show you kind of my decision on where I want to put this, and then I'm going to take it over and press it really good before we put it on to our front piece of our bag. Okay, so you know what? Anything you want to do, I just kind of wanted to show you that you're not stuck doing one thing. You can put it here in the middle. You can bring it up to the very top like this. And for this bag, I really want to show off the pink. So what I thought I would do is bring it down a little bit more than, I don't know, an inch and a half. I think that's going to make it really really cute. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it over to the ironing board, give it a good press, and I'm going to sew it a couple of times along the top, okay? Just two times following each other. Maybe the first one will be a quarter of an inch and the next one a half an inch. But I do want to give that a nice double line of thread. What it does is it strengthens it up there. Okay, so I'm going to do that. And then we'll attach it to the front of our bag. Okay, so that went really, really well. I just pressed it and I did my two little lines of threads. It just makes it stronger, and I think it's pretty. I went ahead and used the pink. I was pretty confident I could do two parallel lines and make it look nice, so that came out really well. Okay, so what is next is we take one of our panels, and this is the part that I like to use my my mat and my little, my large ruler here, and I'm going to put this on here. And you got to always think about where your gussets are going to go, okay? I haven't exactly made up my mind the size of my gussets, but I'm going to say I want them to be probably 5 inches when I'm done. I want a 5-inch corner when I'm done. So that tells me I need to stay about 2 1/2, 2 3/4 inch up from the bottom. So I'm going to take my board here, and I'm going to do 2 1/2 from the bottom. 1, 2 1/2, and then I'm going to add a quarter to that. Let's see, 2 1/2. Actually, you know what? Let's just make it really simple and put it on the 3-inch. I don't want to go down below 3 inches with the bottom of my pocket. Okay, so I'm going to set this here. And line it up exactly straight with this. Okay, and I'm just going to put in a few pins, a couple on the sides. And a couple along the bottom, making sure that I'm not changing where this is actually sitting. This bag is so, if you use the fleece, you're feeling right now how fluffy and wonderful this bag feels. It's very, very soft and squishy, which I think beach bags should be. Okay. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take it over to my sewing machine. I'm not going to take you with me because you've seen me do this before. But I'm going to sew this 1/4 inch up with my pink thread again. Just one time. I don't need it two times, but just one time. And then we're going to decide where we're going to place our pockets, okay? And okay, so it is attached to the bag right now. And we're going to decide where, I want you to think, if this bag is made for you, you can get really personal with it and decide maybe you want a whole bunch of, you know, certain size pockets for different things. But I don't actually know who's going to own this bag, so I want to keep it pretty simple. And I am thinking I can make two lines right here to make three different equal size pockets, okay? So you don't want to get a line really close to the edge here because you make this a mute part of the bag, okay? It just won't be functional for really anything, maybe a pencil. But you better hope it doesn't go down deep because you'll lose it, okay? So just keep kind of those things in line. So what I'm going to do, 21 inches, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set my ruler here in the middle, make sure that it's even and square exactly where I want it. Okay, that looks really good. Okay, so this is my 6-inch ruler, and I'm going to go ahead and place it here. And I'm going to put two pieces of tape right there. That's going to help me to make a really nice line. I don't want to mark this. I'm just going to go ahead and use the tape. But if you feel like you want to mark it with a piece of chalk or whatever, you know what? That's great. Go ahead and do that. But this is just kind of my little trick that I do when I don't want to use chalk or anything like that. So I'm just going to set this here. Painter's tape has very low tack, so it's not going to leave anything on your fabric. No sticky goo. Okay. All right. So now I'm going to take it over to my sewing machine, and I'm going to sew on the inside of these two lines, and they're perfectly placed with the measurements that I've decided I wanted to match. Okay. So I'll be right back. Okay. I really like that pocket. That looks really good. Okay, very, very nice. That's the front of our bag. We are going to put an inset zipper, if you would like, into the back of the bag. So we're going to set this one aside. I do want to put my Vicki Lee bag brand right about here. So I'm just going to remind myself before we put the bag together that that's where I'm going to put that. I'm going to set that aside. Okay, so I made a video this last week, and it's how to put in an inset zipper. I'm going to run through this a little faster than usual because I don't like for the people that follow me constantly that you would have to see the same thing over and over and over. So I am going to go through it, but I encourage you, if you haven't done one of these inset pockets before, that you review that, and it'll make this make a little bit more sense. I'm going to run through it, but it's going to be a little bit quicker than usual. Okay, so here is our zipper pocket. Set the zipper aside for a second. And I didn't have to interface this because it's a very, very heavy fabric, but you're probably going to see interfacing on the other side of this. And so what I'm going to do is open it up. Now, mind you, this pocket is 15 inches wide. Okay? By 20 and a half long. Look at how nice this pocket is going to be when it is in the bag. You're going to have lots of outside storage for whatever you would like. Okay? Okay, so what I need to do is center this, and remember our rule of thumb is it needs to come down, the zipper needs to be at least 2 inches away from the top. The pocket, it can be anywhere in here, but I'm going to set it right there. So now you have right sides together. You only draw on your interfacing, so it's wrong if it's turned the other way, okay? Centered, and that's about where I want it to be. Okay, so there's the halfway point, and it's not in the way of gussets or anything, so I'm really, really happy with that. I'm going to pin this on here. We're going to stay an inch away from the sides because we're going to create a hole right here to put our zipper behind it, okay? Down at least 2 inches from the top. 1, 2 at least, and this is where I'm going to come down exactly 2.5 inches, okay? Let's see, 1, 2.5, 2.5. And this is where I'm going to draw my very first line. I need to stay an inch away from the sides, so I think I'll start, I will do it exactly at 1.5 inches, I think. Yeah, perfect. Remember, you can make yours custom to how you want it. This line needs to be nice and neat and straight, so I'm going to come in 1.5 inches here. Okay, so there's my line. I'm going to come down 1/2 inch, exactly. And now I'm just going to fill this in. Okay. This is the time you take it over to your sewing machine. I'm actually going to take you with me because you'll probably would like to see this. If you haven't done it before, at least you'll get a little example of what that is like. Okay, I do need to put my zipper on. This is where I really encourage you to be as precise as you can. My stitch length is going to be at about 2.5. Okay. Go very, very slow because you want a beautiful straight line. Exactly on the corner, pivot, I realize I'm going pretty fast, but many of these, so, but take your time. There's no extra points for going super fast. And I'm on the home stretch. I'm going to do one little back stitch. My large ruler and my cutter. Well, before I do that, wait a minute, just a second, I'm so sorry. Before I do that, what I want to do is I'm going to draw a line in the very center of the half inch, which is a quarter inch. I'm going to go ahead and draw a line. And then on each corner, I'm going to draw a V, about a half an inch from here to here. It doesn't have to be perfect. And then I'm going to do it on the other side as well. Okay, this is where I pick up my cutter now, and very, very carefully, from the tip of the V to the tip of the V, you're going to cut through all layers with your rotary cutter or scissors if you feel a little, you know, more comfortable. I'm comfortable with this, so it's fine. And I'm going to press down and you're going to hear it go through all the layers. Okay? Hold it tight. And stop right at the V. Then I take my small scissors and I'm going to cut into, but not through, my corners. Into, but not through. Okay, here comes the fun part. You're going to take the whole entire pocket, top, sides, bottom, everything, and you're going to push it through your new opening. All of it. Turn it over. Okay. What I like to do at this point is you can see on the back here that if this padding is getting in your way and you can pull it apart a little bit, you can cut it away. I don't worry about that too much, but some of my friends do. They actually pull that padding away so it's not so bulky. It does not bother me, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. But if you've done this before and you think, oh, yeah, I would really like that, then go ahead and do that. Okay, so this is the part where you're going to go to your ironing board, and you're going to really take your time and fold this whole piece back and give it a good press. If you want a little of the lining showing, great. If not, you're going to have to really work at it. I do want a little bit of this lining showing. It's a beautiful white, and I think it'll look really nice. Then, and take it down here. Pull this down too. And I usually take a few minutes and finger press it first before I take it over to the ironing board, and I use a little bit of steam. But I get this rectangular part really nice before I even attempt to do ironing, okay? I really just work with it first so I don't get a funky-looking rectangular opening for my zipper. Okay, so I did iron it back, and it came out really good. Very, very pleased with that. So I'm going to take my zipper, which is way long, but that's okay. I'm going to leave it at the length it's at. And I'm going to put it underneath here. And bring it just to where the zipper pull is. Okay? And the idea is to take it over to your sewing machine and sew it all the way around, very, very close to where your lining meets the outside of the bag here. Okay, you can, you want to make sure you catch the zipper tape underneath, but you don't want it, you don't want your focal fabric to be too close to where you can't open it. It gets caught in the fabric. So go ahead and, you know, spread this out just a little tiny bit, and make sure you have an even distance between the teeth and the side here all the way down. So I'm going to adjust my camera again and show you how I do this one more time, and then our zipper will be in, and then I'll show you how to sew up the pocket. Now, at this point, I mentioned this in the last video, if you're more comfortable pinning it on there, by all means do that. I'm not. I've done so many of these, I just take it over like it is and just keep watching it and adjust it as I'm sewing, okay? But if this is the first couple of times you've done it, you may want to go ahead and pin it in place, or, you know, whatever method you may do. You may have some sticky tape, you know, that you use, and all of that works. It doesn't matter how you do it. As long as you're happy with the end result, you want it to look really nice and neat. This is the outside of your bag. So let me adjust my camera again, and we're going to sew this. So I come down a little bit. I don't start where the zipper pull is because it's actually, it'll move out of the way and give me a very, very crooked stitch. So I'm going to start well beyond that. Doesn't really matter where you start, except that I like to start closest to the top. And I'm going to make sure it's aligned beautifully how I like it. So close to the edge that you run the risk of it falling off onto the zipper tape, but you don't want it real far away either. It's very important that this looks really, really nice. I am being very bold. I'm using my pink thread, so hopefully that'll work okay. I just go slow and I adjust my zipper as I go, exactly in the middle where I do want it, okay? Okay. That was fun. I'm really glad I used the pink. It came out really nice. Kept with the little theme of the bag. Okay. Cut away your threads. This part I'm going to go ahead and leave. It's not in the way at all. But of course, this is way too long, and I don't want to cut it right off at the threads, but I don't want it, you know, out here either. Because what we're going to do now, and I'm not going to take you with me, I'm just going to show you what we need to do. So I'm cutting off about a half of an inch away from there. And look, I'm going to save this and put a new zipper pull on it and use it for another project. Okay. So what you're going to do now is you're going to go over to your sewing machine and you're going to take your pocket and fold it up here to the top. Go ahead and pin it all the way around if you'd like. I'm just going to put a couple here at the top. And it's really up to you where you want your seam. You can be close to the edge here if you would like, or you can come in a little bit more. The only thing I want to caution you when you sew this, because you're going to sew it from here all along the top and back down. You don't need to sew the bottom. That's already ready. So when I take it over to my sewing machine and I begin to sew, I'm going to pull this whole thing back. I don't want it anywhere near sewing up this pocket. And then as I come around, I'm going to stop what I'm doing, fold this all the way down, make sure it's not in the way, and then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Okay? So we'll compare notes when I get back. Okay, so you can see that I went all the way around and it came out good. I'm really happy that I made a large pocket. Boy, when somebody goes to take this, they can put so much in there. It's actually a very nice large pocket. So I hope you're happy with this part of the bag. It is optional. You don't need to have this, but it's very rewarding if you do. So guess what? Now we're going to go over to the liner, which is extremely simple in this design. I didn't put a lot of anything on the inside. It's actually a very, very quick project. So we have our two pieces. We're only going to work with one because all we're going to do right now is to make this little guy so that somebody can hang maybe their keys or, you know, anything else that they want to hook this little swivel hook to. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to do just like a strap. Take this over to the ironing board. I'm not going to worry about the raw edges because after we get done with this, and by the way, this does not need any interfacing, I'm going to iron it towards the middle to make a crease, put these to the side and fold it over. That way I can fit it through the little loop on this, and the whole entire thing is going to hang probably on the side of the bag, not the very middle, but over here, so somebody can hang their keys and they're nice and deep into the bag. So I'm going to go ahead and iron this, put this on, and then I'll show you what I'm going to do next, okay? Stay tuned.
Okay, so I did finish my little strap, and I put my little swivel hook on there. And you can place that anywhere you want on the inside, even the outside of the bag, if that's where you want it. But I chose the inside of my bag. So it's a really good length. It's about 8 inches down after it's been sewn up. So what I'm going to do now is set it here, and only within the quarter of an inch line, I'm going to go ahead and sew it down a couple times so it's really, really strong. Okay, so I'm going to do that. And then if you want to put pockets on the inside of your beach bag, go ahead and do that. I'm not going to do that with this bag, so I'm actually done. The next time you see me, we're actually going to be making the straps, okay, so we can sew those on before we sew the bag together. So, let me get the straps ready to go, and we'll start on
those. Okay, so there's nothing really, really special about the strap, except that I did interface them with some light interfacing. I've already done this one before I started this filming of the video, and basically what I've done is I lightly interfaced everything, but then I took about a 16-inch piece of the fleece interfacing, okay? And I put it in the very, very center of the strap. So when you're carrying a really heavy load, it's really nice on the shoulder. It's got some little extra padding, okay? And you only cut it to be the size of one of the, see how this is in fours? So you've got the one panel and it folds and then this folds, so it's in fours. It's only the size of one. Okay, so make sure you cut it only the size of one. This one is ready to sew up. I'm not going to worry about the ends. They're raw because we're going to put it in the bag like that. Okay, so it's got a really nice shoulder strap. So basically what I'm going to do off camera, because I'm going to take it over to the ironing board, is to do our normal strap. But I'm going to go ahead and add my piece of, let me measure this for you. Okay, it's 1 1/4 inches by 12 and a half. Okay, it is a little shorter than what I first thought it was. And you want it to fit within those, one of the four little panels, creases that you're going to iron into it. You don't want it to be, you know, sloppy, because it'll open this up when you're trying to sew. It's got to actually be inside there the same size, okay? So I'm going to do that, and I'll see you back here.
Okay, so we're at the point where we're going to put our straps onto our bag before we put our whole bag together. And, you know, one of the things that I really like to do first is to find the very center. And how I do that is I fold it in half, and I make a very small notch. Don't go into the seam line, but just enough for you to see that little notch that's there. Turn it over and do it again on this side. Okay. And that helps me to find my center beautifully. Okay. So now I'm going to put my bag on my mat. And here is my center. You know, I have made so many bags, and that also means I've made so many mistakes. And when I first started making large bags, I had the tendency to really spread my straps out, thinking, well, you needed to. Well, what happened when I did that is when I put on the bag, the whole bag had a tendency to want to kind of fold into itself. But I have found for better balance to have it a little bit always closer to the middle than further out. If you're going to have a cross body strap, that's one thing, because you wear it across your body and you keep the bag apart. But when you just have it over your shoulder, it's different, okay? All right, so that's just a little knowledge for you there. So I'm going to keep mine. What you want to do is make sure that your strap is completely even, no kinks. You don't want it turned in any way, shape, or form. So I say you always start with, you know, the horseshoe. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, we're going to put the notch right on a line, and I'm going to say with this bag, 1, 2, 3 inches over for the inside of the strap. That's a really good space. Here's my notch. Count 3. 1, 2, 3. Make sure my strap is straight, no kinks, not turned. And I'm going to put the inside of the strap right here. I'm going to do that with the other one on the other side, making sure they're perfectly even. I'm going to take them over to my sewing machine, and staying within the 1/4 inch, I'm going to go back and forth a few times. Another piece of knowledge is when you go back and forth over something, try to move it a little bit. So when your line is here initially, come back from it just a little bit and go across, because you don't want to perforate it. Okay? So here we go. I'm going to do this with this one. I'm going to do it with the back part, and then I think we're ready to put our bag together. That's exciting, huh? We're getting there. Hi there. Okay, so we did put the straps on, and they're long, but that's okay, because if you have a really heavy bag and you want to wear it crossbody, most of us can. You can shorten them. You can make them even longer, whatever you want to do. Okay, so we're at the point where we can actually put this bag together. We are pretty much done with everything. So what you're going to do is you're going to make them face each other. You're going to line up your little V's at the top. And you're going to pin all the way down your sides and across. When you get to your handles, just tuck them in and make sure that they're not in your way. It's going to make it bulky in the middle, but that's okay because you pinned your sides. It's really okay. And then make sure when you come around and you sew your focal fabric on the outside that you take a good enough bite on your edges. Okay, you don't want to do a quarter of an inch. I'm going to say at least a half an inch. And you may want to do it twice. Okay, so just on the inside of that first seam, just a little tiny bit. Kind of like how I did our straps here. I did not go over the same spot over and over. I went just a little bit over so I can get a bite of more of the fabric, okay? So go ahead and do that, and do that with your lining as well. And leave a gap at the bottom of your lining. You've seen me do this so many times, but for somebody that's new watching, you're going to put right sides together. You're going to pin it just like the other one. You're going to come down and like this. But when you get to the very bottom here, what I want you to do is, as you sew, I want you to stop about 5 inches in and do a back stitch. Do not sew any of this. This is how you're going to turn your bag. Then you're going to come over here and you're going to do some back stitching and then come all the way around. That way you have enough room to reach in there and turn your bag through. Okay, so I'm going to do all that off camera and we're almost done. Okay, so we did sew up the sides, and what we're going to do now is figure out where we want our gussets. I can actually fill the pocket on the outside, and I want to go within that. I don't want to sew or cut into the pocket, so I can actually feel it there. So what I'm going to do is, where I feel the pocket is exactly at 3 inches, so I want to come down a quarter of an inch from there, and I'm going to measure in. I want my gusset to be kind of as large as I can get it without cutting into my pocket. So I'm going to put it at 2 3/4 up and 2 3/4 over. I don't have a template big enough for this, like you've seen me do another bag, so I have to do it the old-fashioned way. Killing me. And let's see, we're going to actually measure from the outside edge. Remember I told you I never do that? Well, guess what? Never came. Because I'm going to go ahead and do that today. I can feel my pocket right here at 3. So we're going to go at 2 3/4. And I'm going to draw a line as straight as I can. 1 2 3/4 right there. Make sure it's a good line you can see. 2 3/4 this way. Okay. So one of the ways that you can do this too, it's kind of cool, is to go ahead and cut it out. And you can use this corner piece as your template for the rest of your bag. Remember, you still have 3 more to cut out. You still have your lining gussets to cut out. So this just is a quickie way to do that. So set it down in the corner and just trace it. So for this bag, what I want you to do is I want you to reach in like this. Put these two together. Okay, one seam going one way, one seam going that way. So you're not going over this really big bump right here. Especially if you use the fleece. It can get, you know, a little bit thick. Now you only have a quarter of an inch to work with before you catch that pocket that's on the outside, and you really don't want that to happen. It's not the end of the world. I've done it before, and I've had, you know, good result. It's really, really okay. But if you don't have to, that would be great. And you can actually see your pocket seam and just feel, and you can follow this line that's right here. I'm going to really like this bag. It's a really awesome size. And remember, you can make them much bigger if you want. It doesn't really matter. When we get done with our design series, you guys are going to be so awesome at making bags and teaching me. I just know it. I can't wait. Okay, so I'm going to take this to my machine and make sure I'm catching it on both sides. I can see where, I can feel where my pocket is on the outside, so I'm going to keep it right there at a quarter of an inch. It's perfect. And I'm going to go over it a couple of times. I want this really, really strong. Then I'm going to do the exact same thing with the liner. And then when I come back, we'll be ready to assemble the whole entire bag. Okay? Okay, so make sure your lining is pretty side out. And your outside of your bag needs to be turned inside out. Okay. And I like to put the straps on the inside. I deal with long, bulky straps. Okay, so now what I do is I take my liner and I'm going to put it inside the bag. Don't worry about your straps right now. We're going to deal with those in just a second. Just kind of stuff everything in there. Make sure your little strappy strap is in there. I like that thing. Okay. Now reach in through the hole of the bottom of the liner, and if you would like, pull your straps through a little bit so they're not so bulky around the sides. See that? I'm just kind of pulling them through. Because what you want to do is make sure you have a really good fit in your bag. Line up your two side seams. One goes one way, one goes the other, to avoid all the bulk that we've talked about. And give it a pin here on the outside. Okay, go to the opposite seam, do the same thing. It's a really soft bag. I really like the feel of it. It's just perfect for what we're doing. It's great for a picnic. It's great for a weekender. Okay, and then take the middle of both, line up seam to seam. That helps you find the middle. And pop a pin in the very center.
And then just add pins every 2 to 3 inches, more if you need it, and less if you can do with less. And put a pin all the way, go in all the way around, and then push your pins down. Give it a little stretch between pins so that you can make sure it hugs the other side of the bag, okay? Getting to be my favorite part. I love pulling it through. Remember, we call it birthing the bag. This will be very easy because we left our slot, you know, at the bottom nice and large, and it's a very soft bag, so it'll be very easy. Okay, I've got all the pins in I need. It looks really good. The lining fits well. It's not too big. If you were to find that it was too big, what you would do is take it out and sew up one of the seams just a little bit tighter, a little bit. Okay, so this is where I like to take off my part of here on my the arm of my sewing machine. Maybe, maybe not. Oh, for goodness sakes. Okay. Get everything out of my way. This is where it gets real busy. Again, it doesn't really matter where you start, okay? It really doesn't. But this is the part where I like to make my stitch length as large as I can get it. My machine digitally will go all the way up to 5, and I like to do that so that if something goes wrong and I have to take it all out, it's a nice large stitch. So let me adjust that. Because when we go around to sew it up, I will bring the length in quite a bit, okay? So we're going to start here, anywhere. Doesn't really matter. And I'm going to make sure that it's lined up with the side of my bag. Don't make it too skinny. You want to, you know, take a nice chunk out of it. You've got the room. It's a really deep bag. I'm going to set my needle down and very slowly just inch it along until I meet that line when I get to the other side. Going slowly. My favorite part. Woohoo! Never pull your straps. Go ahead and pull the lining out of the bag. Grab one corner, squeeze it, and gently start the process of pulling it through the hole. So this one's going to be really easy because it's a very soft bag. Okay. So what I like to do now is before I sew up the bottom, I push the liner back in and I just give it a really good once over. Make sure that everything fits. I've done everything, you know, correctly. There's probably no need to pull it through again, so that's really good. Boy, the pockets came out nice. It is seated. We've talked about seated before, where the actual bottom of the bag is square with the pocket. That came out really good. I just love that. Okay, so here we go. This is it. All we have left to do now is to press the top all the way around. Decide if you want some of this showing or if you want it to be flush. That's completely up to you. And you will see this part right here just comes directly out from the top. But when you do a top stitch, this will be folded over like that and it will force it to stay down. If
If you don't want that and you want it to just be either way, avoid sewing over that at all. And you can have it pretty versatile. It's long enough you could anyway. Okay, so this is getting close to the end here. I'm going to go ahead and press this and sew up the bottom. And we're done. Isn't that a nice bag? Boy, it's nice and large. It's very attractive. It's washable. It's dryable. It's durable. It's adorable. Okay, so this is Lynne from Vicki Lee Bags, and I hope you enjoyed making this today. Make it a great day.